Hypertension is a common condition that presents with elevation in either systolic or diastolic blood pressure and represents a major risk factor for morbidity and mortality. It's one of the major causes for premature death on a global basis, and in many countries is the most common reason for physician visits. Increased risk for hypertension-related complication occurs at blood pressures of greater than about 115 millimeters of mercury systolic. However, the threshold blood pressures for initiating treatment range from as high as 160 over 100 millimeters of mercury for those at very low risk of hypertension-related cardiovascular complications to as low as 130 millimeters of mercury for those at highest risk. The corresponding target blood pressures based on those thresholds are 140 and 120 millimeters of mercury systolic blood pressure, respectively. Hypertension is most commonly due to an excessive elevation of peripheral vascular resistance, not adequately compensated for by adjustments in either intravascular volume via renal mechanisms or in cardiac contractility. The most significant factors affecting these variables are the sympathetic nervous system, the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, and regulation of plasma volume via the kidney. Primary hypertension, previously known as essential hypertension, is a diagnosis in more than 95% of cases. Its development has been related to numerous genetic and environmental factors, with combined effects on the central and peripheral nervous systems, on cardiovascular and renal functions. Secondary causes of hypertension account for less than 5% of cases and include renal and endocrine causes like primary hyperaldosteronism, pheochromocytoma, and thyroid disease, and exogenous drugs, including non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs and street drugs like cocaine. Management of primary hypertension is based on health behavior changes and on risk factor modification, as well as achieving target blood pressures through the use of antihypertensive medications and regularly scheduled blood pressure monitoring. Management of secondary hypertension is based on the same considerations, plus, in some cases, treating the underlying condition. Malignant hypertension is the presence of a sustained and symptomatic highly elevated blood pressure. The blood pressures associated with symptoms of malignant hypertension can be highly variable and can sometimes be only minimally elevated. These symptoms can include dyspnea, chest pain, and those consistent with an encephalopathy. Eye signs associated with malignant hypertension include retinal hemorrhages, exudates and papilledema. Malignant hypertension requires urgent treatment before it leads to irreversible end organ damage.